Sea Vision Productions presents The Southern Pacific Steam in the 1950s in the San Joaquin Valley of California, from the films of Dr. Wayland Paul Matt. We begin with cab forward locomotive number 4281 leading a Christmas special on December 23, 1954. Here the train is leaving Tehachapi. Heading to a high vantage point, Dr. Matt captures a freight train with another cab forward. Dr. Wayland Paul Matt was a railroad doctor for both the Santa Fe and Southern Pacific in Bakersfield, California during the 1950s and 60s. This gave him the opportunity to photograph many steam locomotives in the West. The yard at Bakersfield was one of Dr. Matt's favorite places to film. Here we see GS4, number 4449, stopping and pulling out of the yard with a passenger train. The 4449 still operates today by the Friends of SP 4449. They are a nonprofit organization dedicated to the restoration, maintenance, and operation of the former Southern Pacific Steam locomotive based in Portland, Oregon. Dr. Matt captures another train on Tehachapi in 1954. One of Dr. Matt's favorite ways to shoot the steam trains was pacing along with them in the San Joaquin Valley on Highway 99. Here he gives chase to cab forward number 4281. On December 30, 1954, Crane Bucyrus assists in cleaning up a derailment near Tehachapi. Thank you. Back to more pacing scenes of cab forward number 4281. GS4, number 4476, is in charge of a freight heading out of Bakersfield. Thank you. At Bakersfield, the 4472 heads into the yard. Southern Pacific number 3673, which is a Baldwin F-4 2102, is being shipped in a freight train, probably to a scrap yard. In the 1950s, the Southern Pacific was in the transition of dieselization, which was bringing an end to many of the steam locomotive careers. Cab forward number 4227 is also mid-train. It is interesting to see the refrigerated reefers with the ice hatches open. On December 1st, 1957, Dr. Matt follows a California, Nevada, and Pacific excursion led with cab forward number 4274. On October 12, 1958, we see GS4 number 4460 leading another excursion train. Back in the yards at Bakersfield, we see number 2827, which is a 280C9 Baldwin switching the yard. Soon, the 4431 approaches the camera as it readies to back onto its train. More action at Bakersfield, this time in the form of a fire truck. After the fire truck excitement, Dr. Matt gives us a look at the roundhouse. Number 4458 leads this train out of Bakersfield. Next, we see the 4439 heading out of Bakersfield. Thank you. Now stopped, the 4439 waits for an opposing freight, led with two diesels. Back in the yards at Bakersfield, we see a variety of yard action from Dr. Matt's camera on May 30th, 1954. On November 17, 1953, we pace along with Mountain MT-4 number 4353 as it leads a freight from Lurdo to Bakersfield. This is an SP-built 482. November 19th, 1953, and we are once again in Bakersfield, where number 3734 rolls by clanging its bell. Also, number 4467 is preparing to take train number 51 with 9 orange and yellow passenger cars out of the yard. Number 3689, which is a Baldwin F-4 2102, wastes no time with its train through the San Joaquin Valley on June 16, 1953. Thank you. Shifting our attention away from the San Joaquin Valley, we now move a little east to view the narrow gauge operations on the Southern Pacific. This line ran through the Owens Valley from Laws to Keeler, California. Here we see number 18 in charge of the train. This is a narrow gauge 460 locomotive built by Baldwin Locomotive Works in 1911. This locomotive is now on static display in Independence, California. These scenes were captured on August 20, 1954. The SP abandoned this line in 1960. At Owenyo, which is north of Keeler, we see the crew doing some switching and interchanging of the freight cars. Thank you. Here we see workers taking out wood ties from the standard gauge boxcar and loading them on the narrow gauge flat car. This scene shows the Baldwin, which was originally built for the Nevada-California-Oregon Railroad, being turned on the hand-operated turntable in Laws. Back to pacing in the San Joaquin Valley, we see antique SP steam locomotive number 2248 with a diamond stack as it travels from Lurdo to Bakersfield. This locomotive and tender was captured on August 30th, 1956. three men roll on a handcar in Bakersfield as number 4439 moves in the yard past a set of F units. In August of 1956, 2102 F5, number 3737, is in charge of a freight. In April of 1961, Dr. Matt captures SP2 4102, number 5021, sitting idle at the Pomona Fairground, just east of Pasadena. Number 3669 is cruising along as it heads to rescue a train with a locomotive failure. SP number 4476 and its square tender take care of this fast-moving freight train. Here we get to see some great drive rod action. This is train number 51, led with the 4431. It is leaving Bakersfield with a passenger train in September 1955. The 3669 is now seen with a train rolling through the San Joaquin Valley. Now we see the 4476 in charge of the Cotton Belt train in September of 1955. let's take a look at more Bakersfield yard action taken on October 9, 1955. Thank you. Number 3737 is seen along Highway 99 and will soon pass the station at McFarland, California. In this faded scene, we see 484 locomotive number 2728 being shipped to a scrapyard. Our last steam locomotive in our show is 464 number 3696 coming into Bakersfield Yard. Closing our show, we see some diesel operations. SD9, number 3923, leads this train through Tehachapi Loop. Here, Dr. Matt captures scenes from Bakersfield Yard in the diesel era. This huge yard was just as busy with activity in these scenes as it was in the steam days. We sure hope you enjoyed our look at the Southern Pacific in the 1950s. Thanks for joining us.